Let's solve the Advent of Code 2021 Day 4 puzzle using Ivy. I have the sample and input ready, and in this puzzle, we are playing bingo with the given boards and the given sequence of number draws. When we draw a number, we'll need to cross it off our boards, which we can do by replacing it with minus 1. The Ivy operator in checks each input against a sequence of values, so those are the locations of the 1s, 2s, and 3s in the boards. To cross those off, we can bitwise OR in negative 1s, where those are. And so let's package that up. Now we need to be able to check for a win. Let's play some numbers so there's something to check. Okay. Now in this puzzle, diagonals don't count, so a win happens when an entire row or column is minus 1. The first and second board both have wins now, and we can see that more clearly by making Ivy look for the minus 1s. Now before, we've seen the slash operator reduces a vector by applying a binary operator to it. So plus slash 1, 2, 3 applies plus to all the elements producing 6. We can reduce every row with the AND operator to find which ones are all 1. And then we can reduce the vector of row wins with the OR operator to find out which boards have a win. Oops. So the first board has a win. We didn't find the second board because we didn't look in the columns yet. To look in the columns, we need to flip the boards. Now a direct transpose of B doesn't do what we want because it reverses all the axes. And we want to keep that first dimension, the actual boards, in place and only reverse the next two, which we can do by specifying the axes to transpose. And so then we can look for wins there and we find the second board. So the overall win operation then is to look for row wins or look for column wins. And there we have both boards. When we do identify the winners, we need to calculate their scores. And the score is the sum of the values remaining on the board. We can remove the minus ones by multiplying B with B greater than 0. And then we can add those up. And those are the scores of the three boards. So let's save that for later. Now we need to run the sequence of draws and stop at the first winner, computing the drawn number times the board score. So if we have the win vector and the boards, we want to extract the board that won and print that score. Now the last time we worked around Ivy not implementing multi-dimensional select, but my copy now has it implemented. But it's not exactly what we want, because the problem is that in APL and therefore in Ivy, select applies to the last index, which is the columns, but we want to select on the first index, which is the boards. Now we can do that by transposing the result of the selection and the boards being sent into the selection. And that does, in fact, give us the two winning boards. So let's save that board selecting operator for later. And so here are the scores of the winning boards. All right, so the puzzle asks us to play the draws one at a time, determine the first winner, and then compute the score of that board times the final drawn number that led to the win. So to do that, we'll define an operator winner that takes the list of draws and the boards, and it will start by drawing the next number and updating the board. And then we have to look to see if we have a winner. We can reduce over wins of B to see if any of them are 1, and if so, we'll take the score of the winning board, multiply it by the number we drew, and we're done. Otherwise, we'll do a recursive tail call on the remaining draws back to winner with the same set of boards. So now we can say sample draws, winner sample boards, 4512. That is the right answer. So then input draws, winner input boards. Let's see. All right. Now in part 2, it says, why don't we try to lose instead? So let's find the board that is the last one to win, the loser, and figure out its score. So let's say we're going to do loser. And then in the recursive call, instead of passing all the boards, we'll filter out the ones that won so that we keep having just the losing boards move on. So we can change this to loser of, what is it? Not winning. Selected from B. And then in here, we want to stop when all the boards have won. Typically by then we'd be down to one board. But if there's any losers, we want to continue. So all the boards have won, and then we just do the same score. So let's see how that goes. Sample draws, loser sample boards. That is the right answer. Loser input boards. Here we go. And we got our stars. Have a nice day.